Today on Typical Books, I have a whack of books. I went to dReadCon. What is dReadCon, you may ask? Well, nobody knew up until this Saturday the 14th. In a very hot September day, the day after Friday the 13th, which was perfectly fitting, was the inaugural first annual Montgomery Burns, the first annual dReadCon. And it happened in Waterloo, Ontario, Canada. And the reason I'm so very, very excited is that we've never really had anything like this. I mean, there's genre cons and there are fantasy and science fiction conventions in Canada. Not very many. There's reader conventions. There's the Great Writers Festival here in Ottawa every year. It doesn't really have a lot of good science fiction and fantasy. My friend Kate Hartfield is there all the time, so if you love fantasy books and want to see a really cool author talk about them, she's usually there. I'm going to CanCon this year, where a lot of science fiction, fantasy, and some horror people do hang out, but it's not quite like DreadCon. It was 90% dealer's room, which is fantastic, and 10% programming. And not to say that there were very few panels, there was panels continuously throughout the day, and I didn't even get to see them all, and there was only like one at a time, I think, which was really cool. I only saw one reading too. Like, I felt like I missed so much, but I was visiting all the authors. DreadCon was held on the grounds of the University of Waterloo, and I had not been to the Kitchener-Waterloo area. I really enjoyed the area, and it had all the amenities that any horror fan would like: coffee and a place to have a convention. But I am really looking forward to this. It was put on by Erie River Publishing, and I believe CM Forrest, the author, helped organize this event. It was sponsored by I don't know who else and Rue Morgue. So it was very cool to see Rue Morgue, see Andrea there, and see Horror Writers Association authors there as well. I got my copy of Einhallow signed by Tim McGregor, which I don't have down here. I have it upstairs. But yeah, I was very excited about that fact. Incidentally, I will have a review of Einhallow coming up very, very soon. But he did have a little chick tract of The Devil's Funny Papers, and I was very pleased to see this fun thing. And I think that it's a teaser for work he has forthcoming, I think. So yes, like I said, it's like, for me, it was 90% dealer's room. There were so many authors there, and not just authors, publishers as well, and rare book collectors. Fred, whose name last name I forget, this gentleman had so many signed editions. If you're interested in the contact information for some very cool signed Ed Lee, I got to see an original copy of the novella for Header. Like, that was amazing. So much signed Jack Ketchum, so much signed Richard Layman, and Joe Lansdale out the wazoo. If you're interested, let me know in the comments and I can figure out a way to get you his contact information. For really serious collectors only, I'd say, because his stuff is kind of pricey and one of a kind in a lot of respects. From his table, I picked up Jeff Strand, The Pressure. He recommended this to me because I'd not read any Jeff Strand, only a novella that was a little campy. And this, he says, is serious as a heart attack. So yeah, signed Jeff Strand. It was not too expensive either. Neither was this copy of True Crime. And I've been looking for this. I originally read True Crime as a Kindle, and I felt silly that I had done that when this had fallen out of print for the Grindhouse Press edition. There's a new edition out, but yeah, I was very pleased to get this cool looking version of True Crime. Not signed, but still, very cool find. And there were other tables nearby with random books. I'll continue talking about the books I got from booksellers. This is from Little Ghost. It's a Toronto bookstore. I believe it's Canada's only horror bookstore. And I've not been there yet, so it was really cool to be able to meet the owners and pick up Gone to See the River Man, the book everybody talks about that I've been looking for. You don't really find this in normal bookstores, right? So yeah, my first Christopher Triana book. And from Ex Mortis, who is a rare bookseller as well, I picked up Hounds of the Tyndalus, or Tyndalos, however you pronounce it. I've always said Tyndalus, Hounds of the Tyndalus. But yeah, This is Ex Mortis. I used it as a fan because it was screaming hot in that hall for whatever reason. It was a very hot day for September in Canada. But yeah, this, I walked by it because I thought it said $55. And I walked by it a couple times going, oh, I don't think so. Until I stopped and said, hey, is that a 5 or a 3? And because it was only $35, and I say only $35, I had a specific budget. And I will tell you, I spent every penny. And adjacent to the Rue Morgue table is one of their editors, I believe their book editor or an associate editor, Monica Kubler, and an author in her own right, of course, had her former press, Burning Effigy Press, some very special editions of little chapbooks that she had unearthed while moving from a press that no longer exists. So these books are basically going to be impossible to get someday. And I was very pleased to pick up a few of these and chit chat and hang out with Andrea, harass Andrea and Monica for a bit and pick up a copy of the Nosferatu anniversary edition of Rue Morgue for my podcast partner, Wes, as well. I was really pleased that they were sponsoring this as well, because this is like the first year of a small con. They ended up with very good turnout. So I hope that this will return every single year, even if it's in Waterloo. It's not very close to me. It was a 5-hour drive. I didn't take a lot of photos as I was there. There was a nice walking trail near the hotel, so I took a photo of that. One photo of the lineup, a photo of the floor as I walked in, and one photo after a panel that featured I. Jiang, CM Forrest, and Tim McGregor. And it was hosted by Rick Hipson from Rue Morgue. So that was a really cool panel. But yeah, I didn't get any photos because I was just very in the moment. I was also starved for coffee and focused more on buying books. So yes, onto the author's tables. I already had Bad Blood by Tobin Elliott, and I have all of his other books in this series on my Kindle. So I really did want to get print editions someday, and I figured, what better time than the time I get to see Tobin, an author friend that I have not seen in 13 years. We figured that out, and he had edited some stories. So if you've read Preloved Eve 1 and I believe 2, and my book Night Face, which is out of print now, he had edited those, a lot of the work in those. So yes, I picked up the entire series. And I will say that this cost more than that copy of Hounds of the Tyndalos by Frank Belknap long by far, but is it more than worth it? Absolutely. To see a good friend, to get signed copies of an entire series of books, nothing quite like it. It was amazing to see Dale Long and Tobin Elliott, writing partners, at their table and harass them for most of the day. It was fantastic. I'll just hold Bad Blood to represent the entire stack because it's a lot lighter. This is based on a novella, Vanishing Hope, and it's a retelling of that novella entirely. So if you've read old Tobin Elliott, then this is that story retold. And what's neat is that we had met because of my old publisher, and I was at a Rue Morgue Festival of Fear years ago with my publisher and meeting up with Colin McKnight, who ran a blog, and Melissa wasn't there because she was American. We're all Canadian. So yeah, it was very a Canadian author hangout. And I believe it's through Colm that I was introduced to Tobin Elliott and his work. Became a big fan, became friends. He became my editor, and the rest is history. This, if you're into monsters and terrible children and haunted books, cursed books, telling people to do things, this is a really good gateway into the series to see what you think of it. I'd also got to spend time chatting with Tim McGregor about the state of horror conventions like this, and what's coming up next. So that was amazing. But I didn't purchase any books there, and I didn't purchase any books from the two stars of the show, who maybe the stars of the show. I think Tobin and Tim were the stars of the show. But we also had Craig Davidson, who you may know as Nick Cutter, and Andrew Pyper, who we now know as Mason Coyle. I didn't get any books with them. I didn't get any photos of them. I chatted with them after when they were signing and got program signed because I had interviewed them more than 10 years ago, I think, here in Ottawa together as a team. And here they were again together as a team. And I got to see their panel. So that was extremely cool. I really hope to see them again if there's a reboot of this or at the next convention, where maybe I'll have a copy of William, which I did not know was by Andrew Pyper, and I'll get my copy of Handyman Method signed, maybe. Ai Jiang was an amazing addition and catch. I did not realize she would be on panels. I thought she would just be there. I'd pick up a copy of Ling Hun, which I wanted to read for a very long time. I didn't realize it was a novella. I thought it was a full-on book. And I've said this a couple times about other books. It's like, oh, I didn't know it was so literary. I would have read it earlier. Yeah, I didn't know that this was a novella, but here we are. So yeah, I was very excited to pick this up from the author. It's a signed copy. Very, very pleased. But to hear her talk about folk horror on the folk horror panel alongside Tim McGregor and CM Forrest was fantastic. I could have sat there a whole entire other hour. Of course, I could not pass up some CM Forrest. The roots run deep. It's not all folk horror, of course. There's a mixed bag of all kinds of stuff from what he says. But yeah, very interested. This is an Erie River Publishing book as well. So I get a chance to see what their publication quality is like. No doubt it's fantastic. And I'm still very pleased and thankful that they put on this amazing convention. Second last, Liz Worth. I've seen her at other conventions. I've talked with her before. I've done readings at Convention for Postscripts to Darkness. There was reading nights. I believe we both had stories in there. And I've also read her book about punk rock in Toronto in the 70s. The Mouth is a Coven. I love this cover. I love the typography. I love the use of color or lack thereof. Otherwise, I loved it when it came out, and it's another one that I wanted to get to, didn't get a chance to, and I'm so pleased to get a copy from the author. So yeah, very, very, very impressed with the lineup. There were so many authors, 50 authors. So this very small clutch of books, which is actually pretty big, actually, I do admit I bought too many books, but I could have spent another day going through all of the authors. There was a panel near the end that we went to see about indie authors, and I just, lack of coffee, the overheating in the sun earlier, anytime I went outside it was boiling hot and it was pretty warm in the convention floor too, I just ran out of steam. I should have stayed another hour and visited with each author in turn. I really wish I could have, because there were so many. I know I would have spent more money, but maybe next year I'll visit with all of the indie authors that I don't know first and save all the others for last. I was gonna say best for last, but how do I know that? There could be all kinds of gems on the floor in front of us that I walked by. And last but not least, I got Doors of Darkness, 27 Tales of Terror. All sorts of authors are represented in here, but my favorite points here, it has an introduction by fellow booktuber Cameron Chaney. So hello, Library Macabre. And a very cool cover, which I thought was a Cameron Rubik cover, but it's not. It just really looks like it. And my friend Tobin Elliott has a story in here. So I had known that this came out and I plumb forgot about it. It wasn't until the very end of the day I said, oh yeah, that book. I'm going to have to take that too. So yeah, very pleased to get a collection of 27 stories. This is so very old school. This is the sort of book I would have bought as a teen and been like, yeah, cool. Introduce me to 27 new horror authors, please. So yeah, very pleased with this. I am so excited for more. If there isn't more, I will scream and cry, because it was such an amazing, valuable convention to bring horror authors together and not be crammed in with science fiction and fantasy. And I'm sure for big fans of all the genres, that's great. For fans of just horror, it's not. So I really look forward to something like this coming around again. I look forward to a horror convention that isn't only a media convention. Like I said, this was a lot of books and booksellers, but it's real meet space authors you can interact with and talk to. And A lot of them were on panels and a lot of them had readings. I would handle another day of this. So a 2-day convention would be really, really, really valuable. This, as a 1-day convention, was more than I could ask for. I absolutely loved it. So thank you to all the sponsors of DreadCon for putting this on and the University of Waterloo for housing it. And yeah, hopefully we get more of this. Have you gone to any really cool conventions? I know in the US they have so many more, and it's so much easier to get to if you're central or close to some of these horror hubs like Pennsylvania or California, but or San Antonio actually. But yeah, if you've gone to any really cool conventions that are new or that a lot of people just don't go to, let me know in the comments below. Maybe I'll get to one day. It's a lot easier on the East Coast, but yeah, let me know, and hopefully I'll see you at DreadCon next year. Thank you for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.